Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Komal from Shekhawat and I hope you all are doing good. In this video, I'm going to discuss the random effect model and the fixed effect model. So this video is in continuation with the previous video, which was on Hausman test. So do watch that video before watching this one. I'm also attaching the link in the description box. So let's start with it. So here, after running the Hausman test, once you have found out whether fixed effect model is more appropriate for your data set or random effect model is more appropriate, okay, you need to run the model accordingly. So I'll discuss again, in case of Hausman test, the null hypothesis is that random effect model is more appropriate, whereas the alternative hypothesis is that fixed effect model is more appropriate. And if the probability value is less than 5% of significance, level of significance, then we reject the null hypothesis. Okay. It means that we are rejecting that random effect model is more appropriate and we proceed with the fixed effect model. Okay, so in case of my data set, the probability value is less than 5% level of significance, it is 0.029. Okay, so this means that fixed effect model is more appropriate. So in that case, you need to report the results or the regression coefficients result of the fixed effect model only. Okay. So let's first have a look how we can run the fixed effect model. So after running your Hausman test, okay, you need to go to estimate and this was your regression equation. Then in the panel options, you need to select fixed, okay. In the cross section block, select fixed if the Hausman test suggests that fixed effect model is more appropriate, okay. Now click OK. All right. So these are the results for fixed effect model. The regression coefficient of all the variables, standard error, t statistics and probability is given. OK, it is calculated by the software. So if the fixed effect model comes out to be the appropriate model after running the Hausman test, you need to report the results of the fixed effect model. All right. However, suppose the Hausman test suggests that random effect model is more appropriate for your data set. So steps are very easy. You need to go to estimate again and in the panel options, instead of fixed, you have to select random over here. So select random and click OK. So these are the results for the random effect model, okay? And in that case, you need to report the regression coefficients, t statistics and probability value of the random effect model for your particular data set, okay? But whether to go with the fixed effect model and whether to go with or with the random effect model, you have to first run the Hausman test. Okay, so through these simple steps, you can run the fixed effect model and the random effect model accordingly. I hope you like the video. Thank you very much.